Brigantia Blackbird of the Blackbird Grimoire. Welcome to the daily forecast for Monday, November 11th, 2024. It is the 24th of Scorpio and the Day of the Mother. And it is also, of course, Veterans Day in this country. So we want to honor everyone who served, whether they are still surviving former members, current members, those who were killed in action as well. This is everyone who has joined the military in order to defend the nation and, of course, also our rights. And I wanted to share this quote from Abraham Lincoln with you today. He said, "America will never be destroyed from the outside. If we falter and lose our freedoms, it will be because we destroyed ourselves." And I think it's very obvious that a lot of people today, the ones who are constantly calling for censorship, the people who act as though it's a calamity when someone has opinions that differ from theirs, those who are insisting that other people have to affirm their moral values, those are the people who are doing a very good job of destroying American values. And whether it's the people who have more of a theocratic sensibility, who really think that their faith should really be dictating things, or the woke. The woke, they are just as intolerant. They are just as inflexible. They are every bit as much evangelistic, insisting that people accept, believe, and give at least lip service, convincing lip service, to all of their, what they consider their moral preconceptions. The theocrats and the woke, as far as I'm concerned, they are on the same coin, opposite sides, but the same coin. It is about that inability to understand that while you are free to exercise sovereignty over your own beliefs, you are not free to impose that upon other people. And where people can come together on American values and constitutional values, it's about the things that we generally all agree on. You know, don't go around killing people. Don't go around stealing people's stuff. You know, basic things like that, people can actually get around. And that's really the foundation for what American tolerance is all about. And also it's a foundation for American culture, where you can come here, you can be yourself, you can build up a life for yourself. You just have to understand that it's not for you to impose upon someone else. And that's something that I think that Lincoln really understood, of what our founding fathers understood, and what, you know, I think recently we saw that there's at least a majority of people in this country who do still understand that. And those who don't, I think this is an opportunity for them to really go back, reflect, think about how much they believe is the result of media propaganda, and how much is what they actually think, and maybe do a little bit of adjustment and think about, you know, maybe I have been too heavy-handed. Maybe I do go around expecting the world to change in accordance with my desires, rather than me really focusing upon implementing change in my own personal life. So, few thoughts for that, and of course, be very thankful to the vets and sensitive to their needs and their preferences at this time. Now for our astrology, the sun is in Scorpio, fixed water, representing resourcefulness. The moon is second quarter Pisces, mutable water, representing dreaming. Mercury is in Sagittarius, mutable fire, to be opinionated. Venus is in Sagittarius, mutable fire, representing generosity. And then at 12:26 p.m. Central Time today, it moves into Capricorn, a cardinal earth sign, and then Venus becomes very reserved. Not unfeeling, but very reserved. It's going to take a little bit more encouragement to bring those emotions up to the surface and fully expressed. Mars is in Leo, fixed fire, representing focus. Jupiter is retrograding in Gemini, mutable air, which is to broaden perspective. Saturn is retrograding in Pisces, mutable water, which is to redefine dreams. Uranus is retrograding in Taurus, fixed earth, representing rebellion. Neptune is retrograding in Pisces, mutable water, which is spiritual awakenings. And Pluto's in Capricorn, cardinal earth, representing reconstruction. For our retrograde reminders, for Jupiter, reconnect with your true path. For Saturn, reclaim your authority. For Uranus, reconsider how you rebel. For Neptune, reclaim your magic. And for Chiron, restore the heroic spirit. Our moon is still that waxing gibbous, so it's time for us to cultivate our intentions. We are still in that Pisces moon, so our do's are compassion, creativity, and charity. And our don'ts are over-socializing, being too rational, being too one-dimensional. So tap into your emotions and remember Veterans Day today. The reason why previous generations of pagans have successfully established legal rights and standing is because of the American constitutional system has been successfully defended and upheld by our armed forces, some of which do include our own brothers and sisters. In Arlington now, there's a certain pagan iconography that they do permit on the tombstones of the fallen. So we are a world away from where things started over here, because it was really in the 1960s, after we had a few of our British cousins reawaken our pagan roots for us. That's when the paganism really started retaking root in America again. So honor the warriors, honor the ones who fought literally, and also honor the ones who fought for us inside of the court system. We are in a much better situation today than we would have been if they had not answered that call. And I don't know if you can hear the sirens. I apologize for them. Not much I can do. It has been a pretty hectic morning for emergencies in this neighborhood. So best wishes to whoever those people are requiring the services. But anyway, today's tarot is the Empress. She comes from the Major Arcana, which means that her meaning of her card will have expansive impact upon us. This is going to be a heavier energy that will last longer and have more consequences. She's number two in the lineup of the Major Arcana, and twos represent partnerships and rivalries. And her keywords are motherhood, poise, and nurturing. And you do get that idea from this image. You see someone who is certainly of motherly age. She's making a presentation. She's calm. She's relaxed. She's confident in what she's saying. She knows what she's saying. She's not, really fighting off stage fright or having to make up for a lack of knowledge. And, she's obviously prepared for nurturing. She's showing us her cookbook, Recipes for Success. She's wanting to offer us guidance. And remember also that in the tarot, the Empress does represent feminine divinity, whether you are thinking of the ultimate goddess or any of the other goddesses that were familiar to our ancestors. The Empress does broadly represent those goddesses. This would also be a good day, perhaps, to reach out to goddesses that we are familiar with and are working with, or perhaps to form a new relationship if we've had something different crop up in our line that's more so in the wheelhouse of a different deity. This is a good day to reach out. And it's also a good day for us to cultivate a mature feminine energy. Femininity is not about, constantly flying off the handle over our emotions or, being conniving or any of the other things that we stereotypically are accused of being, with some justice. That's not what true femininity is. Femininity is not the collection of our flaws. Femininity is really a conduit of power. You think about it in the most physical sense, with our wombs, when a child is conceived, that womb becomes the conduit for the formation of new human life. And magically, on the feminine, more feminine side of magic, when we're working with that more receptive energy, we are having things flow into that conduit so they can be transformed and made into something that is greater focus, that has increased purpose. That's really a powerful thing, and that's what femininity is all about. So I think this card we could be using perhaps as a focus for meditation today, or as that nudge to reach out towards anyone who might guide and mentor us. Today's Celtic triad reads, three things of which not the half is to be believed that is boasted about them. Wealth, understanding, and goodness. The wealth is pretty obvious. Many a person has become preoccupied with appearances and giving the appearance that they are wealthier than they are truly are, because they think it gives them greater status in the image of and the eyes of other humans who, in the social circles, these kinds of people tend to be in, the people they're trying to impress are also doing the exact same thing. Very rarely do you find an authentic bone amongst them. It's very sad because, it not only does it mean that no one in that situation is really being genuine, it also means that people who have this particular weakness of character, they're more likely to try and live beyond their means because they're trying to impress. It's not about making a solid investment. It's not about choosing something of quality that's going to last a long time, maybe even be passed down to other generations. It's not about learning to manage money well. It's just about I'm going to put on a show. I don't know about you, but I think we need a little less show in this world and a lot more authenticity. I mean, if you have money, fine. And if you want to invest that in a house, there are architects and interior designers and construction workers and a myriad of people who will have gainful employment if you choose to go that route. I don't have a problem with that. I do have a problem with people trying to do something that they can't afford. Then understanding. And the people who generally boast of their understanding and their wisdom tend to fall quite short in those departments, and it's evident in their behavior. And certainly, I don't know how many times I've emphasized on this channel. I have my own personal shortcomings. I mean, the most that can be said for me is that I personally am trying, and that I'm trying to spark conversations about how we can all apply pagan principles a little bit better in our lives. But you know, that's about as far as it goes. Really, is as far as it goes. I consider myself more so an absorber of wisdom or anything else, and trying to convey that to other people, because we can all benefit from it. There's very little wisdom to be found in the world outside of pagan circles. And then the matter of goodness. It's much easier to claim to be virtuous than it is to actually practice it. It's much easier. It goes back to this idea of putting on a show or trying to impress people with this this false premise, this false appearance we try to give them. It's so much easier that it is to do that than it is to simply go out and do something worthwhile. It's easier to make a show of, oh, I donate to this charity or that charity, than actually investigating, you know, first of all, is the charity doing what it claims to do? Are the donations actually benefiting the people it's intended to benefit? Because that really is a problem. There's a lot of people out there who are scammers, and that is so sad, because it makes it that much more difficult for people who want to be charitable in order to be charitable effectively. But you know, it's easy to put on these fronts. It's easier to do that than it is to actually volunteer, you know, at a soup kitchen, or to you know, maybe, you know, knit little baby blankets for mothers who are in need, or to go out and volunteer and help people do reconstruction who've been affected by natural disasters. It's easier to talk about the virtue than it is to do it. And so I would really take this as an exhortation to just start walking some of the talk. You know, you don't have to make a big show. You don't have to do everything all at once, but just start walking your talk a little bit every single day, and see how much further you get for it. Now, today's correspondence is the goddess Sif. She is the wife of Thor, and she's strongly associated with farming. In particular, she's linked with the wheat fields and the story of her getting her hair cut by Loki without her knowing. It actually is a metaphor for the harvest. He'd cut off her golden locks, just as the golden stalks of wheat are cut down in order for them to be harvested and us to get the benefit of it. She represents abundance and possessing the means to live well. And there isn't a whole lot that is really known about this goddess. While I do, of course, recommend hitting the books and learning what you can about her, if this goddess is appealing to you, but also to not hesitate to just start reaching out, you know, make her an offering, say, I would like to learn from you, and just wait to see what kind of intuitive nudges that you get. You know, you might not convince anyone else in the pagan world of the guidance you're receiving, but that's not really the important thing. You know, over time, as we all start comparing notes, we'll start noticing patterns and saying, oh, okay, so this is the way particular deities are reaching out to us. You know, we're not fooling ourselves here. But of course, there will always be those who are strictly academic. If it didn't come directly from the past, it doesn't count. And there's just nothing you can say to those people, and you can't really talk to them either. But for your own personal practice and for your own benefit, don't be bashful about reaching out and trying to form these relationships. Next up, today's practices. Our quote comes from Kitchen Witchery by Carradine Greenleaf, and it is a recipe for power potpourri. It consists of 1/4 cup dried rosemary, 4 dried bay laurel leaves, 1/8 of a cup dried sage, and 1 teaspoon dried juniper berries. And what you do is you simmer these ingredients in a pot of water or in a small crock pot, because crock pots are electric cauldrons. I will die on that hill. And then as that blend starts fusing together, it will infuse your space with protection and transformation of baneful energy into beneficial energy. And for my witches out there, putting a little extra magical oomph, telling it to actively do those things will give it even greater effect. But if you're not a practitioner of the craft, you can still get the ambient benefit of these energies. They will still be there. They just won't be as directed as what someone like me would be able to do. But don't let that put you off. And now for today's Thanksgiving fact. Americans also take part in races popularly referred to as turkey trots. The Buffalo Turkey Trot is an annual 8K, which is 4.97 miles, Thanksgiving foot race in Buffalo, New York, each Thanksgiving day. The race proclaims itself to be the oldest continually running public foot race in North America, having established itself in 1896 and ran every year since, even during World War I, the 1918 flu pandemic, World War II, and the coronavirus pandemic of 2020. Isn't that rather a comforting thought that, you know, Come hell or high water, no matter what is going on, we are going to have our Buffalo Turkey Trot every single year. We don't have a whole lot of these constants in our culture, and I hope over time, as you know, hopefully the country does endure, that we will start having more things that, you know, we have always done this thing. This has been always been one of our traditions. You know, we can't remember, you know, a time when we did not do this particular thing. Having these public common rituals, even though, you know, there's, you know, I wouldn't say that there's anything spiritual about that. Although if you're a pagan and you ran in one of these races, you could certainly, you know, dedicate your efforts to one of the gods who are known for being more strenuous, perhaps one of the messenger gods, who of course have to be very speedy. But it's something that we can all share as a culture, and it's important to have these cultural ties. You know, these things, they might not seem like much in and of themselves, but they actually are the glue that helps people come together and recognize each other as being of one people. And I think, you know, being this sense of being of one people, that is something that Americans could really use right now. Then we might offer a prayer of gratitude to a female deity today. We could greet the dusk and carry some selenite. Now for our journal prompt, what female teacher or mentor do you feel gratitude for having known or learned from? And like I said yesterday, this could be someone you knew from school. It could be someone you know from the workplace. It could be someone whose videos or you watch on YouTube or whose blogs you read. Whatever that person is who has taught you something in a way that has actually really helped you in a manner that has sunk into your soul, that's someone to feel grateful for. And just to journal a little about today. And that is what I have for you, gang. Have a magical day. I will see you again here tomorrow for the next edition. Leave your comments and your thoughts in the comment section below. And I, of course, will see you in the next one. Bye for now.